A local library enters a dramatic shooting simulation, preparing for a tragedy it hopes never happens.
We do bring a live shooter in, and the reason is because we want it to be as live as possible, as real as possible, so everybody knows the situations.
The A.L.I.C.E training at the Dyersville Library is our top story tonight on LCTV News.
Good evening, I'm Matt Resnick alongside Sarah Rochford. Fire drills and tornado drills have been standard practice in schools for years.
But with the number of shootings at schools and other public places this past decade, shooting drills are now becoming more common. LCTV's Maria Adolphs participated in one of these drills at the Dyersville Library last week. She joins us now with the inside look. Maria?
Matt and Sarah, Dyersville officials tell me that deadly shootings like those at Columbine and Sandy Hook Elementary were the unfortunate inspiration for these realistic shooting exercises. They say it's a practice they hope they never have to use.
At first I was just surprised that we had to do it because, as we talked about in the training, I mean, you think it's a small town.
In a small town like Dyersville, it's hard to imagine a shooting at the library.
Ridiculous that these days we got to teach students and faculty that a real shooter situation.
The library staff wanted to be prepared in case that situation ever happens, which is why they underwent A.L.I.C.E training. A.L.I.C.E stands for Alert, Lockdown, Inform, Countdown, and Evacuate.
Active shooter scenarios that if a live shooter comes into a building, we give out information to make sure people can survive.
During the training, the staff went through three different shooting scenarios.
It was scary. The first time that we did the simulation, it was the typical lockdown. He went into the room next door first, and you know that he's coming to you next, but I could just hear him pick off everyone else, and so it's a horrible feeling.
The first scenario showed that there are options other than hiding under tables, and people can escape during a shooting.
I got shot in my back the first scenario, and it still kind of stinks a little, I will admit.
The other two scenarios included the library staff trapped in a back corner far away from their safety zone.
That tunnel vision, like all I was thinking of is he was going one way and I was trying to get unnoticed around the other direction.
The training was realistic and scary, but participants say it was beneficial.
You don't know what you're gonna do until a gun is pointed at your head.
Hearing those shots fired brings it back to A.L.I.C.E and its main goal.
I mean, the main thing is I want everybody to survive.
Safety, safety!
Sarah and Matt, I thought this was an interesting simulation. It felt real to be in that one room and the shooter was in the next room and you could hear him come in and shoot us. So I thought it was very beneficial.
That is absolutely fascinating, Maria.